first thing that ever made me feel like a normal person. So many displaced people all in one place made me feel like I was part of something, probably for the first time in my life.
I don't know, it's a way to force into existence something that otherwise wouldn't, that nobody cares about, and the only reason to do it, really, is because you have to do it.
At least you're choosing to use the means you have to give yourself a space in the world where you're theoretically in control. Like Joey said, being able to like keep tabs on people's bullshit, create a space that's fun for everybody, and just kind of, I don't know, be able to have a place in the world where you can just fucking go wild and do constructive things.
It teaches everyone how to be themselves and hopefully the most true person that they can be.
Thank you. This trick's called the sarcophagus.
Simplest trick in the book, but I just did it.
Fucking Latin nose manual.
Ooh! Damn.
No, I don't even fuck it. I don't even fuck around with Hellraiser.
Fuck! Fuck!
2008, the very, very, very end, so basically 2009, my first band, some people, both of our demos were no longer around, and some people had asked me, you know, hey, are you ever going to make these again? And I was like, no. And I was like, well, maybe. And then I ended up, you know, following through, and we played this fest in Florida, and I was like, fuck it, you know, let's make these tapes, and that'll be the first release, and it just went from there, you know, just, you know, my shitty hardcore band, and then my next shitty hardcore band, and then other people's, you know, better bands, and then they, you know, it's, it really just started to document something that nobody else was doing, you know, and I think that that's cool, like, this regional, like, vibe to labels, you know. I think that there's labels in Texas and Olympia and New York that are doing that, and that's what I wanted to do, just document Northwest Indiana and you know, little parts of Chicago that people maybe didn't know about or care about, and I did, so I wanted to see it there. Realizing what you're capable of, you know, building something that wasn't there before, making something that wasn't there before, and nobody asking for it, really, you know. I think that somebody asking for it, or somebody demanding for it, or just, you know, commissioning you to make this thing, you know, it takes a lot of the heart and the soul and the love out of it, and the hate, and, you know, all of the, you know, those negative emotions too. I think that's the merit, you know. It's not about, you know, what's cool. It's not about what's even appreciate it, really, you know. Like, there's a lot of bands that I think are incredible because of what they're making and what they're forcing out there, and I think it's just about what you can do and what you can do for yourself, and seeing people over and over and over again just making what they make and doing what they have to do to live and grow is powerful. It's just, it's an incredible thing, and I want to see that all the time, all over. I mean, I think that one of the things that I'm most negative about is I think that there's a real lack of, people don't really give a shit, you know? Like, people, and I think it's fine to have fun, but I think that there are a lot of things that can be addressed. There's a lot of things going on in this country by, you know, I think that once Obama took office, a lot of people were just like, yeah, fuck it, you know? Like, it's not Bush anymore, and, you know, he's just as bad in a lot of ways as that guy, and not even that, like, on this, like, large global scale in our communities and stuff, you know, just people getting kicked out of their homes and people getting, you know, people not being able to make enough to support their families or eat or live or anything like that. I want to see punks take that shit on, or at least care about it, form an opinion, or, you know, not let people hurt people based on gender or race or sexual orientation or anything like that, you know, respecting each other. And I think right now, because the people are just, like, interested in, like, let's look cool aspect of it, a lot of that is lost. But the positive thing, I mean, there are so many people, like, still doing what they gotta do, you know? People creating, and young kids expressing themselves. And then you take a look at, like, things like Fed Up Fest or Smash It Dead Fest. You know, you look at people, like, building a community where it doesn't exist otherwise. And, you know, that's what I'm excited about. I'm excited about all of these bands on this fest that played, and the bands that, you know, they're connected to and they're friends with, you know, because obviously they come from a good place. And, you know, I want to see that continue. And like I said earlier, during the set that we played, like, I do focus a lot on the negative because I maybe am just a super negative person, but there's so much good out there, and there's so much that it doesn't matter what those other fuckers are doing. Like, it matters what you're doing and what makes you happy and what makes you proud to, like, be a fucking punk and just keep doing that. And, like, you are fucking happy doing that, and it's fucking comes from your heart, and that's what makes you a fucking freak or, like, need this shit, then fuck it. Don't give a shit about what anybody else thinks and just fucking do it.
Texas. I love it.
I'm happy you guys are here, man.
Thank you.
reason to be in a punk band is if you want to be in one. I feel like I'm struggling with this now that I'm, like, a little bit older, and I'm finding that I don't, not because of my age or anything, but just because, like, I have, like, a career-type job. It's, like, a salary sort of thing. And it's, like, I'm kind of dealing with punk on a, in a different way than youngsters. But, I mean, like, the younger generation, I'm dealing with punk in a different way than the younger generation kind of thinks about it, in that, like, it's still, like, very much a part of my life, and, like, it, you know, it governs almost everything that I do. Like, everything that I do runs through, like, a punk filter, more or less. It's, and so I struggle with that all the time, and I have, like, severe social anxiety, and that may or may not be a direct result of, you know, punk rock being a part of my life. You know, it may or may not be, but I think whether or not, I mean, if you're in a band, it doesn't fucking matter. It's weird because I've been in a band for so long. I've always been in bands. I've been in bands for the past 15 or something years. I don't know. It's hard to imagine not being in a band, and that's really what I'm dealing with. It's like, I don't know how to, I'm struggling to keep punk in my life, or to keep, like, this music and, like, this outlet, playing the music that I want to do and doing it in a different way, and trying to be original and, like, even artistic about it. I think that, like, if you're a youngster, if you're like a early 20s kid or a teenager, I think that, like, you know, the merits of being in a punk band are, I mean, I think that it's noble, and I think keep doing what you're doing. How does the music fit in to what I'm doing now and what I'm dealing with now? Things are taking importance, you know. There was a time where, like, punk was the most important thing to do, as weird as that sounds, but it's not necessarily that way anymore. It's just that everything runs, like I mentioned before, it's like everything runs through the filter of punk. It's just like everything kind of, like, runs through that lens. I see everything through that lens. It all runs through that filter, but that's not the most important thing. It's just how I think about things. You don't have to be in a band to be punk, and being in a band really means nothing. But if you've been in bands as long as I have, and if you've played music as long as I have, and if you think about things the way that I do, I don't know, a bunch of people do, then I have to play music. I really do. Like, I feel like I have to. And if I don't, then I don't know what I'm doing. So that's that.
We'll be right back. find the rat hole.
Thank you.
enough now to where people support your band, come to shows and help you tour?
Yeah, and it seems like it's way more friendly now than it was a couple of years ago. Like, it's like people are down for punk right now, and they're also down to like just be friends, which is really cool, because it kind of sucks going somewhere and like just sitting in a parking lot by yourself. Instead, you go out to a show and be like people will just start introducing themselves or something like that, and it's really cool to be like, because we have like friends all over now, and that's my favorite part about being in the band in 2014.
Definitely less hostile.
Yeah.
We'll be right back.
I want some more pizza.
We'll be right back. And it's good right now. There's a lot of good people involved, and people are involved in other kinds of music, but it all is based around there. Because it seems to be the magnet that draws people to it. It brings in a lot of creative people.
Thank you.
Feel like the reason we still do this, and again, it's a very personal thing, changes for everybody, for me, because of what I've grown, the person I've grown into, it's the only thing I feel is still, and not at all times, but it's still the most true form of music. This, I would have to say, you can vent, you can be yourself, you can talk about topics that most people would shy away from. A lot of the topics that Who's talks about aren't always comfortable, but it's because I question so much in so many different aspects of everyday life about how people that we all conceive as norms, how can they live with themselves on a day-to-day basis. I feel like this lifestyle can make you a free person on your own terms. I guess that would be the best explanation I have to why I continue to live the way I do, and the way hopefully most of us all do. So I'll leave it at that.
God.
We'll be right back.
What's up, Will Mecca?
I just went to jump and he was like, oh!
My sub, my chicken sub.
This is overhyped. Fucking sucks.
Drive away!
Beat on the brat! Beat on the brat! Beat on the brat with the baseball bat! Oh yeah! Oh yeah! Oh ho! Oh. Oh yeah! Oh yeah! Oh ho! Oh. What can you do? What can you do? With a friend like that, though it's not your friend, what can you lose? What can you lose? you tell them? Why can't you tell them? With a friend like that, that is a sophomore. What can you lose?
Beat on the brat, beat on the brat, beat on the brat with the baseball bat. Oh yeah, oh yeah. Beat on the brat, beat on the brat, beat on the brat with the baseball bat. Oh yeah,
oh yeah.
Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh ho! What can you do?
Fuck off, you wanker!
You don't get paid, we don't get paid. I got you.
Car wreck? I got you.
Need an attorney? We got you.
Need a hot dog? I got you.
I got you.